to show you our feedback amplifier trainer kit. Order code is 36310. So this is the trainer kit. This is mimic diagram given on the trainer kit. This is current series feedback amplifier. This is voltage series feedback amplifier. This is voltage shunt feedback amplifier, and this is current shunt feedback amplifier. This is main switch to turn on or off the kit. This is the user manual, patch cords. These all are included in this kit. And to do this experiment, we will need an audio frequency generator and a DSO. Our first experiment is current series feedback amplifier. So for this, we need to give. First, we need to give power supply here. Now we will need to give 1 kilohertz sine wave here. So this is the circuit diagram of current series feedback amplifier, and these all connection are inbuilt, so we don't need to do any we don't need to build any additional connection for this. So I am giving 1 kilohertz sine wave here. Keep the switch without feedback. This is without feedback position, so keep the switch at this position and we will observe the output here. Keep the level at minimum possible position. This is my minimum level. So now increase the level. Like this. And leave it where the output waveform is starting to get distorted. So this is where it is starting to get distorted. So keep the level there. Now put the feedback switch to with feedback position. You can see the output waveform is exact replica of input, that is sine wave. Now vary the frequency. And so now vary the frequency like this and observe the bandwidth of the amplifier with feedback position and without feedback position, and note down the frequency and draw the frequency characteristics. Now we will see a voltage series feedback amplifier. This is the circuit for voltage series feedback amplifier. This circuit is already inbuilt, so we don't need to build any additional connections. So give input here. First we need to give supply here, we need to give input of 1 kilohertz sine wave. Here keep this switch at without feedback position. This is with feedback, this is without feedback position, and we will observe the output from here. This is the output. So this is the output waveform. Now keep the level at minimum possible frequency, keep the level at minimum position. the minimum position. Now slowly increase the level. Till we get a distortion. Now you can see there is a distortion here. Now keep the level at this position and put the feedback switch with feedback position, and you can see that the output waveform is exactly like the input waveform. So now vary the frequency and determine and observe the bandwidth of the amplifier with feedback and without feedback, and draw the frequency characteristics. So we can see that the steps are exactly same as the previous experiment. So for the rest of the two experiment, that is voltage shunt feedback amplifier and current shunt feedback amplifier, the procedure are same.